September 11th highlighted the duties and dangers of our first responders and what they face every day. As the first on the scene, they put their lives on the line to ensure the continuation of ours.
We will never forget the nearly 3,000 people who lost their lives. First responders, parents, brothers, and sisters. In West Virginia, we remember Dr. Paul Ambrose of Barbersville and Mary Lou Haig of Parkersburg. Their lives were taken too soon, and their families remain in our hearts and in our prayers.
Writer Elbert Hubbard said, "Art is not a thing, it's a way." Tonight, art is a way to remember, to reflect, to share, and to honor. I want to give a special thanks to the faculty, staff, and students here at the College of Creative Arts for making this possible and for sharing the gifts of their talents with all of us.
The events of that day will always be remembered by those of us who watch them unfold in New York City and Pennsylvania, and as it happened in Washington, D.C., where Susan and two of our assistants and I were present. One of those assistants.
Know someone who died on 9/11. Some of us don't personally know anyone who died that day. And yet, on some level, we know every one of them. We've heard their stories on the news. We've heard their stories through friends and families. To the WVU students who are here this evening, many of you were very young, only 10 to 13 years old in 2001.
I would now like to introduce the 2010 Mountaineer Idol, Miss Amanda Hubert, to sing for us, "God Bless America."
Guide her through the night with the light from above.